And I'm never going to say something that I thought was a little bit childish to begin with, and that is, oh, well, Joe Biden's not my president. This may sound like a subtle thing. I know my wife certainly felt like it wasn't a big deal, but it is. It seems to me now that the Supreme Court case from Texas has been thrown out is that the inevitable is going to occur. But well, it was never inevitable, but whatever it was is going to occur. But I will never refer to Joe Biden as not my president. I'm never going to say that. I'm going to say Joe Biden is not the president. It's not when you say he's not my president, it's kind of a conniption fit, isn't it, really? You know, kind of a conniption fit. Well, he's not my president. I didn't vote for him. Look, I had a lot of questions about Barack Obama's political legitimacy in terms of his legality to hold the office, and I still do. But the fact is he won two elections, so he was the president. I'm an American citizen. I have a U.S. passport. Whether I liked Barack Obama or not, I never said Barack Obama's not my president because he was my president. He's president of the United States. I'm a U.S. citizen. But this is different. Joe Biden, I'm not saying that Joe Biden's not my president. I'm saying when he's sworn in, unless some miracle occurs, he's not the president. He stole the election. Everybody knows it. Everybody knows it. And so there's nothing passive about that. Passive resistance, passive aggression is to say, oh, we lost this election. He's not my president. I don't like him. And I'm going to protest. We're way beyond that now, way beyond that. My position regarding Joe Biden is that I will never refer to him as President Biden because he didn't win the election. He did not win the election fairly. Let's put it this way. The amount of fraud that was detected and the widespread nature of it means that I have no confidence in whether he won the election or not. I'm utterly convinced he didn't, but nevertheless, they have allowed the electoral system to reach the point where I don't have the certainty or anything like the certainty that I used to have. So I'm since he cannot defend these charges and makes no effort to defend the charges of cheating or disassemble them or anything. Okay, that's fine. We all know what happened. We all know what happened. Everybody knows what happened. So he can stand there on the, I was going to say stand there and get sworn in at the White House, but I'm sure he won't. I'm sure he'll swear himself in from the basement someplace because of the horrible, deadly plague that's raging out there. But he's not the president. I'm never going to refer to him as President Biden in the way that I did refer to President Obama, because Biden's not the president. To be president of the United States, you have to win the majority of the states legally, and then the states vote, and that looks like what's going to happen, but that's not what actually happened. And until they can come up with a compelling explanation, and I mean a compelling explanation for statistical impossibilities and for what we saw with our own eyes on video camera and hundreds of sworn affidavits and all the rest of it, he's not the president. And since he's not the president, my obligation is not to be a to give him the unity that he's hilariously calling for, and my obligation is not just to make life difficult for him. My moral obligation is to overthrow the bastard by every legal means necessary. And the reason I say every legal means necessary is because the simplest way to lose this conflict is to give these people the authority to actually pick up guns.